The Enhanced Recovery Programme is composed of a number of factors designed to help speed up your recovery after your operation. This class is the first stage of the process in encouraging you to be an active participant in your own care and recovery from your joint replacement. By explaining the journey you are all about to embark on, we aim to better prepare you for your operation and post-operative recovery, and to help you understand what as a healthcare team we are trying to achieve. We hope you will have a better understanding of the goals we are all aiming for you to achieve, so that you are able to return home sooner than would otherwise have been expected.
In a healthy knee joint, the surface of the bones are covered in a smooth, slippery material called articular cartilage, enabling smooth, pain-free movement. In an arthritic joint, the cartilage becomes worn, exposing the bone underneath and making the joint surfaces roughened and deformed. This can make movement and walking painful. Often the joint will stiffen and thigh muscles can become weak. The pain can become severe enough to disrupt sleep and significantly reduce quality of life. A knee replacement involves the damaged bone surfaces being substituted with metal and plastic components. The most common type is a total knee replacement. This involves replacing the end of the thigh and the top of the shin bone with metal components. A plastic insert is then attached to the shin bone component, and sometimes the back of the kneecap is resurfaced with a small plastic button. The components are cemented in place, giving immediate solid fixation. Your knee is always likely to feel somewhat artificial. Your function will improve for a year to 18 months post-surgery. Occasionally, arthritis is confined to one part of the knee. In this situation, your consultant may discuss the possibility of a unicompartmental, otherwise known as partial, knee replacement. This just replaces the damaged part. After your knee replacement, you'll be able to weight bear immediately post-operation. You will have a scar on the front of your knee closed by clips, which will be covered with a film dressing and a bandage. An ice pack or cryocuff will be wrapped around your knee to help reduce the swelling.
You will be asked to attend a preoperative assessment appointment approximately 2 weeks before your operation to assess your general health, well-being and fitness for surgery. Routine blood tests, an ECG heart tracing and a urine sample will be taken. You will be seen by the surgical team and the risks and benefits of the operation will be explained and you'll be asked to sign a consent form. If you take any medication, please bring your prescription with you to this appointment. We also need to know if you're likely to need some help when you leave hospital, if you already received support from social services, a district nurse visit, or you are struggling with any daily activities. This enables us to make the necessary arrangements to support you on discharge. You'll be given 2 cartons of a carbohydrate drink, which is designed to minimise the effects of starving you before your operation. Please take 1 the night before your operation and the 2nd drink before 6 a.m. on the day of your operation. You should have a shower at home before you come into hospital with the antibacterial wash, which will be provided to you by the nurses at pre-op assessment. Please bring the bottle into hospital with you on admission, as it will be used during your stay in hospital. On the day of your operation, you will be admitted to the ward by the nursing staff and prepared to go to theatre. Nursing staff will record your observations, a doctor will draw an arrow on the limb you're having operated on, and your consent form will be checked. A theatre gown and paper pants will be given for you to wear. You'll be able to speak to an anaesthetist before your operation if you have any concerns about the anaesthetic. You'll be given some painkillers designed to be working in your system for pain control after your operation. The operating theatre is either run for a half a day or a full day. If your operation is planned for an afternoon list, you will be encouraged to have a light breakfast before 7 a.m. so that you are not starved all day. A porter will escort you to theatre reception on a trolley about 20 minutes before your operation. Here you will wait before being taken into the anaesthetic room.
In the anaesthetic room, you'll be attached to some routine monitors by the theatre staff, and a drip will be placed in the back of your hand by the anaesthetist. You'll be sat upright to allow a spinal anaesthetic to be injected into your lower back. This will numb your legs for the duration of the operation and for a short time after. We will then lie you down and you'll be given an injection to make you feel sedated or asleep.
On the highest pressure that we can get them on.
Okay.
After your operation, you are moved to the recovery room where the recovery nurses continue to check your observations. Your leg numbness wears off quite quickly once in recovery, and once that occurs, you may start to move your new joint to reduce early stiffness setting in. You may need extra painkillers or treatment for feeling sick whilst in there, and once fully recovered, a ward nurse will collect you and escort you back to the ward. Once on the ward, your observations will be taken regularly and the sensation, circulation and movement to your feet will be checked. You will have a pair of boots on your feet which will pulsate every 30 seconds and possibly elastic stockings. These reduce the risk of developing a deep vein thrombosis. The boots are removed once you are walking, however the stockings are to be worn at all times for 6 weeks post-operatively. You will be given a second pair on discharge, so you have one to wear and one to launder. You will need assistance to get these on and off at home, so please have a think about friends or relatives that can assist you with them. If you don't have anyone to support you with this on discharge, please let us know. The nurse will monitor your pain and nausea and vomiting score and give you pain relief and anti-sickness medication as required. You will be given pain relief regularly. If you need further pain relief, let the nurses know. The bandage to your knee will be reduced after 4 hours of returning to the ward to expose a film dressing, and an ice pack called a cry cuff will be applied. The knee cuff is applied around the knee joint and filled with iced cold water by decanting it from a thermos type flask. The water in the cuff will stay cold for approximately 30 minutes. Initially, staff will exchange the water for you, and then you'll be shown how to do this so that you can apply the ice pack regularly to help control the swelling that naturally develops post-operatively. The nurses will encourage you to eat and drink as soon as possible, and drips will be taken down when your blood pressure is stable. After surgery, it is advisable to drink a mixture of drinks, tea, coffee and juices, rather than just water. Drinking too much water at this stage can affect your recovery. The numbness in your legs will be short-acting so that you're able to mobilise within 4 to 6 hours of returning to the ward. Early movement of the new joint is important in reducing stiffness and swelling, which helps the function of your new joint return to normal once at home. Urinary catheters are avoided if possible after surgery, and you will be encouraged to immobilise onto a commode the same day. This is a good way of starting early movement in your new joint. Some patients with mainly heart or kidney problems may need production of urine closely monitored and will have a catheter placed during their anaesthetic. On occasions, patients struggle to pass urine once on the ward, and a urinary catheter may also need to be placed. We also know early mobilisation reduces the risk of deep vein thrombosis, chest infections and pressure sores. Providing that you feel well and your blood pressure is stable, a physiotherapist or a member of the nursing team will assist you out of bed to stand up, take a few steps and sit back on your bed. If you feel okay, you can sit out in your chair or take a short walk. You'll be given a Zimmer frame at this point, as soon as you're able, we will progress you onto elbow crutches for use at home. And when you feel confident, we will teach you how to do stairs or a step as appropriate. The physiotherapist will encourage you with your exercises until you can achieve a right angle 90 degree bend at the knee, straighten your knee fully and lift your leg in the air unaided. The qualified physiotherapist or the assistant physiotherapist will see you every day until you're able to mobilise independently and manage a step or a flight of stairs, as well as independently get yourself out of a chair or bed. The exercises will need to be continued for several weeks after you have left the hospital. You will be able to progress to walking unaided over a 6 week period. You will find you can progress to walking unaided indoors within a few weeks, but may require a stick or a crutch for outdoor walking. As soon as you feel confident to manage with sticks instead of crutches, or only one stick, you're encouraged to progress yourself. It is advised to use a single stick or crutch in the opposite hand to your operated leg. It is vital that you take painkillers regularly, as when you are working very hard performing the exercises, your leg may become sore, bruised and swollen. If you experience pain which is not relieved with your regular medication, please tell one of the nursing staff. All the leg exercises will minimise the risk of blood clot formation. strengthen the muscles, regain knee joint flexibility, prepare your operated leg for an improved walking technique. The initial aim is to perform a minimum of 5 to 10 repetitions of the exercises 3 to 5 times a day, increasing the number of repetitions as you are able. Generally, frequent short bursts of exercises are best. It is important to find a happy balance. Performing too many exercises may aggravate swelling and pain. Performing too few will cause stiffness and loss of movement. A member of the physiotherapy team will check your progress while you're in hospital. Gaining strength and movement is hard work and takes determination and dedication. You will need to keep motivated about performing the exercise yourself to achieve a good outcome. It is normal to experience swelling that can make the operated leg feel quite solid. Once mobile, you will find the swelling tracks down the leg with gravity too, causing the calf or ankle to swell. It is important to keep varying the position of your leg to avoid stiffness and excessive swelling. Alternating between spending an hour with it down to practice bending and an hour with it straight and elevated. Some people can hear the movement of the components moving against each other. Some people feel the movement and others experience both. Unless it causes significant pain or feelings of instability in the knee, this is nothing to worry about. A sensation of the knee stiffening up can occur if you've been sitting or standing in one position for a few minutes. It will resolve quite quickly if you start to move. A knee replacement only replaces the worn parts of bone, so it is still very common to experience muscular ache, particularly if you've been very active. Keeping your thigh and bottom muscles strong is the best way of reducing muscular ache. Following discharge home, we advise that you continue to elevate your leg and use ice. You'll be given the cryocuff filled with water to take home and chill in the fridge to use regularly throughout the day. If you're using ice directly onto the knee, always place a clean damp layer of towel between the ice and your skin to prevent an ice burn. All total knee replacement patients attend outpatient physiotherapy sessions after discharge from hospital. You can choose from a number of venues and the ward physiotherapist will organise this for you. The hospital that you choose will contact you directly with an appointment. Depending on your choice of venue, the sessions usually start 1 to 2 weeks after you leave hospital. The sessions are usually once or twice a week. To bridge the gap between inpatient and outpatient physiotherapy, we operate an early discharge scheme. You'll be contacted at home by telephone within a few days by a member of the team. They can talk through any concerns you may have about your progress or exercises. If appropriate, they can also visit you at home to review your movement or mobility. When you get home, it is very important to take your pain relief regularly as directed by the nursing staff. If you don't manage your pain properly, things like going to the kitchen to make a cup of tea could be difficult and painful. It's important to gradually increase the number of exercises you are doing throughout the day, but please make sure you pace your activities, don't do all your jobs at once. We advise that you do exercise at least 3 times a day. It is better to do short but frequent bursts of exercises. In preparing for your discharge home, an occupational therapist will assess your ability to manage day-to-day tasks. You should have been provided with a home information sheet to complete and bring with you today. This gathers information on your home environment and asks about equipment you may have already in place. If any concerns are highlighted on this form by the occupational therapist, you'll be contacted by telephone to discuss these further prior to your admission. The occupational therapist may suggest different ways of doing things or suggest help from other people, for example social services, and provide any equipment you may need. It would be helpful to plan for your discharge by doing things like organising your kitchen so that frequently used items are to hand, ensure rooms will be easily accessible while using a walking aid by taking up any loose rugs and moving bulky furniture. Ensure you have support in place for shopping or have stocked up your freezer and cupboards prior to coming in. Occupational therapists will also see you on the ward after your operation to ensure you can do everything that you need to do in order to manage at home. They will assess if you're able to get in and out of bed independently, manage to get on and off the toilet and chair, and manage your own personal care, including bathing or showering. Discharge arrangements are commenced early on in your care and this will be discussed with you. We aim to get you as independent, as mobile as possible before you leave the hospital so that you feel confident to manage your own care. Your discharge home is led by the nurses on the ward, working closely with the physiotherapist and occupational therapist. You will be given an estimated date of discharge of 2 to 3 days after your operation. This gives you and your relatives a date to aim for so that preparations can be made. This date is an estimate and some of our patients go home sooner than this and some patients need a little longer. A letter will be sent to your GP to inform him or her of your discharge and the nurse will make arrangements for the care of your wound and the removal of your clips at your practice nurse. You will be given a supply of pain relief medication to take home. A side effect of the pain relieving tablets is constipation, so to prevent this you will also be given some laxatives. Eating fresh fruit and vegetables and drinking water will also help. An outpatient's appointment will be provided to you to see your consultant or one of the team at 6 weeks post-operatively and you'll be given the contact number for the ward if you have any concerns once at home. You should contact the ward you were discharged from if you experience any of the following: bleeding or any discharge from your wound or redness that seems to be spreading up and down the leg, excessive swelling of the wound area, increasing pain and stiffness of your new joint, increasing pain, difficulty moving the operated leg or walking if you have had a fall. If you experience a problem with your wound healing, it is very important that your consultant's team is kept informed so that we can minimise your risk of developing a serious infection. You will be able to go home by car and it would help if you have already arranged for a relative or friend to be available to collect you as ambulances are not usually required. Swelling is to be expected and can be managed by elevating your leg and regular walking. Continue to progress your exercises, walking and build up your activities gradually. You have had a major operation and it will take several weeks to recuperate. You'll be contacted by telephone within a few days of discharge by one of our physiotherapy team to check on your progress and offer support and reassurance and physio at home if needed. In the longer term, the benefits of having a total knee replacement are less pain, a functional range of movement, a better walking pattern, improved ability to carry out daily activities, being able to return to work if appropriate for you, and to return to those leisure and social activities you've not been able to do because of your arthritis. We hope this DVD has been informative and wish you well for your operation.